Hello and welcome back to Home Comfort Tactics. Today, I'm going to dive into a specific problem that a homeowner in Rockville, Maryland recently had. It was a mystery to them as to why it was happening and was putting a real damper on their new investment. Americans, and today's episode is all about the dew point dilemma. Just recently, I received a heartwarming message from Alex, a homeowner who was struggling with a persistent condensation issue in their new home. Alex described how our intervention has transformed their living experience. No more condensation headaches, no more furnace fiascos, just consistent comfort and a significant reduction in energy bills. Now that's the kind of success story that keeps me passionate and excited about what I do. But let's rewind a little bit to where it began. Imagine being a first-time homeowner, excited to step into your new place, only to be greeted by discomfort and a nagging mystery. This was Alex's reality. Despite the best efforts of multiple experts, HVAC specialists, window salespeople, roofers, the issue persisted, and the worsening discoloration on the living room ceiling was a constant reminder. At his wit's end, Alex found out about the Pepco Home Performance with Energy Star program and learned that an energy audit might actually help. That's where I come in, and I was armed with not only the experience of having done over 2,000 energy audits, but I also carry with me cutting-edge technology and determination to help people uncover the truth. So what I figured I could do is take you through a few of the steps that I took to gather information around this house. Because Alex's main concern was the condensation, I did take a closer look at the window near the problem. That included a trip to the attic area above the window. Immediately, I was greeted by a huge hole to the inside of the house, connected to the furnace, and I thought maybe warm air was bleeding off of the furnace and into the attic space, creating the problem from above. I made my way to look at the area above the window, and nothing seemed out of the ordinary. The insulation was low, of course, and there was no air sealing, but it's not like the area was completely exposed. I actually pulled some of the insulation back and took a few shots, but again, nothing really stood out. Another mention was that the kitchen was cold, so I knew the overhang in the area was likely a source. After doing some health and safety testing on the furnace and hot water heater, it was time to look at the insulation. The crawl space revealed poor insulation and exposed ducts with an open vent on the outside. That's old school thinking and a recipe to make the HVAC have to work much harder to keep up. A trip to the attic revealed that soffit holes for ventilation were covered by insulation in most places. The exhaust fan to get extra moisture out of the house was disconnected, and like most attics, this one needed to be sealed and insulated. During the investigation, I've got to be honest though on this one. It was a little tough to figure out, and I wasn't really quite sure at the beginning what was causing the problem. I had several theories based on the information I collected in the attic as well as the crawl space, but I wasn't sure. I decided to take thermal images of the ceiling, and they proved to be the key to finding out the problem. Ultimately, during the viewing process, the images revealed hidden clues that had eluded previous investigations and provided the pieces to finally solve this puzzle. The culprit, a classic case of temperature clash near the bay window, where warm air from an HVAC duct met the chilly surface on the ceiling. It was a recipe for condensation, especially because the indoor humidity levels were above 55%. Picture it. Warm, moisture-laden air from the furnace encountering a frigid ceiling. It created the perfect breeding ground for condensation. So armed with the knowledge and a clear diagnosis, we were ready to tackle the issue head-on. With recommendations from Energy Star and Pepco, we set out to upgrade insulation, seal the air leaks, bridge the temperature gap, and reduce the indoor air humidity levels. By bringing Alex's home up to modern standards, we slashed air leakage by a significant 43%. According to Alex,
basically, it's like a different house since the work you did. No condensation problem. No runaway oven furnace trying to cook us. We set the thermostat to one temperature, and the house stays comfortable all day and night. We've only had one gas bill since then. It showed something like a 40% reduction in usage compared to the same month from the previous year. Anyway, we're very happy with the results. Alex.
And there you have it. The dew point dilemma resolved through perseverance, technology, and a commitment to comfort. If you're facing similar challenges in your home, do not hesitate to reach out for a professional energy audit. You can schedule yours today with Home Trust Remodeling. Let me help you turn your home into a haven of comfort and efficiency. Thanks for tuning in, and until next time, stay comfortable and stay informed.